Pampered Predator, Victimized Vixen, Gambling Gal Pal. No matter who she's playing, Isabel Jeans got to show off her range in three films directed by Alfred Hitchcock. She is Hitchcock's Salacious Socialite. In her Hitchcock debut, and my favorite of her three performances, Jeans plays a vicious villain, an actress named Julia Fotheringdale. Julia has expensive tastes in cloaks and dresses, and a parasitic financial relationship with most of her boyfriends. The movie is downhill, and the protagonist, Roddy, is going to regret meeting Julia. She meets him as a penniless teenager who's just been disowned from his family. Roddy clearly has a crush on her, but it's not until a relative dies and he comes into an inheritance of £30,000 that Julia starts to show him any interest. Once she does, Roddy unwisely agrees to pay for her expensive tastes. They marry, and it doesn't take long for Roddy's bank account to be overdrawn. When he confronts Julia about it, he discovers she's been cheating on him with another actor. In the ensuing fight, Julia shows that she cares much more about her material possessions than Roddy's well-being. And in a final twist of the knife, she tells him to leave the apartment, because it's in her name. Roddy definitely made some poor decisions to get in his situation, but I think it speaks to Jean's commitment to the character that you can understand why he does. When she's seducing him, she's very gentle and warm. It's only when he's caught in her web that her true nature comes out. Also, her best costume is a shiny pajama pantsuit with fringe, pearls, and fur. It's a gaudy display of wealth that really speaks to the character's over-the-top sense of style. In her next collaboration with Hitchcock, Jeans gets the lead role. In Easy Virtue, she plays Lurita Filton, a woman who's trapped by scandal and uses a young suitor as a life preserver. The setup is surprisingly similar to Downhill, except neither character has ill intent. Lurita doesn't tell her husband the truth about her past, which she definitely should, because it leads to a lot of trouble for her later on once she meets her mother-in-law. But Lurita's never portrayed as a villain. Jeans gives a quality performance, but I'm never completely sold by the film itself. It mostly involves punishing a woman for the indignities visited upon her by a misogynist society, so it's not a great watch. However, Jeans fulfills the requirement of the character, giving the audience someone to root for while all the other characters are mean to her. And now we transition to the sound era. Hitchcock works with Jeans one final time in 1941's Suspicion. It's her smallest part, but it's always fun to see a silent film star transition to sound. In the film, she plays Helen Newsham, a friend of Johnny, played by Cary Grant. Again, Hitchcock casts her as a member of the upper crust. She gets to act opposite Joan Fontaine and reveal that her new husband Johnny is not all he's cracked up to be.
Vices? What vices, Mrs. Newsham?
Oh, such as betting at the races, for instance.
Jeans is excellent at implying a lot with her dialogue. The words alone seem harmless enough on the page, but the way she delivers them is incredibly catty. The character clearly relishes knowing something that Joan Fontaine doesn't, and enjoys playing with her emotions. All in all, Isabel Jeans had a fruitful partnership with Hitchcock. Although her lead performance is in a less than stellar film, she got to play two high society villains that reveled in toying with weaker characters. It's also exciting to see her perform in two different decades, twice in the 20s and once in the 40s, and see that she's just as confident working in the silent or the sound era. Thanks for watching, and if you'd like more videos about directors and their socialites, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on this channel. And, as always, the Saris wheel spins on.